Here at Consumer Reports, they test everyday items that are surprisingly loud. Listen up.
Whoa, whoa, Jack, wait. Hey, how you doing, man? Listen, you gotta wear some ear protection while you're doing that.
Why?
Some of these leaf blowers are loud enough that they can damage your hearing within about 15 minutes of using it. But you're not gonna be able to hear me if you do that right now.
What? Which, did you say something? Oh, hold on a second. Oh, okay, there we go.
Now, I'm all ears to hear how the teams here test common household items to see how loud they can get.
We use a sound meter here.
Huh.
For everything that we test. So you're blowing the leaves, and there's somebody standing up here taking a measurement. This is recording decibels, right?
Going into the ear.
Yep, and this will tell us how loud every leaf blower is and how dangerous it can be.
But leaf blowers are just one of some two dozen common household products tested here.
Vacuums, air purifiers, refrigerators, blenders. Dishwashers, yeah.
Huh.
Yeah, you want me to show you?
Yeah, that'd be great.
All right, come on, let's go check out the lab.
All right, let's go.
Blenders are loud, Jack.
How loud?
Really loud. Most of the blenders in our rating are 85 decibels or louder, which normally we would recommend hearing protection.
So are you telling me that I should be wearing hearing protection when I use my blender?
Well, if you were using it, you know, like a lawnmower for 45 minutes at a time, then yes, definitely. But because you only use a blender for less than a minute or so, usually you're probably okay.
Okay.
All right, let me show you something else.
Sure.
So this is where we test dishwashers.
And not just for how loud they are, but also how irritating.
You can use a sound meter, but there's something that we like to use as well.
Which is what?
The human ear.
Ah, are these the human ears?
So these guys literally listen to the full cycle of every dishwasher we test and make notes about whether or not the sounds are annoying, like the water coming into the machine, draining, which might make a squeaky sound from the pump, the soap dispenser opening up, that clack, you know, does that annoy you when you're sitting on the couch watching TV,
mm-hmm.
you know, and you decide to put on the dishwasher before, you know, before you go to bed? A lot of those sounds can kind of add up into what we call sound quality.
When you're a sound panelist, it's not a sprint, it's a marathon.
How long do they have to be there?
Some of these cycles go for 2.5 or more hours.
2.5
yeah.
hours, and how many machines do you have?
Well, there's over 100 dishwashers in the ratings, so you can do the math on that one.
Yeah.
Shh, quiet.
We're being too loud, Jack, come on. That was great, useful information. Thanks a lot, Eric. I appreciate it.
No problem, Jack. That's what we're here for.
Hey, by the way, there's a family that wants to ask a question. Let's ask CR.
Hey, Jack. I'm Lauren. My brother always tells me to turn down my music in my headphones, but how much damage can it really do?
So what about headphones and music?
Well, prolonged exposure to loud music or noise can definitely cause hearing damage, and that's one of the reasons why we recommend noise-canceling headphones.
Mm.
Because they cancel the outside noise, and it allows you to listen to the music at a lower volume. Less chance of damaging your hearing.
Now back to some unfinished business.
All right, Jack, we can't just leaf this pile here. I think we gotta blow this pile out of the way, but
right.
Safety first.
Always.
All right, let's go.